Welcome to Informed Sources on News Channel 3, the show for the Mid-South's smartest viewers who want the real story behind the big story. I'm Otis Sanford, in tonight for Richard Ransom. Thanks for joining us. We have a power-packed show this evening and a lot to discuss, so let's get right to our topics. State of the unions, as in city employee unions that are stepping up their dispute with Memphis leaders, mostly over possible changes to impasse procedures to resolve contract disputes. We'll examine the war of words that seem to be escalating as contract talks began. Refugee resettlement. State lawmakers finally followed through on their long-held desire to sue the federal government over resettling of refugees in Tennessee from various countries. The suit was filed in federal court in Jackson, Tennessee, by private counsel and not by the state's attorney general. What's really going on here? But first, our hot topic tonight, the president's budget. President Donald Trump made a campaign-style visit to Nashville on Wednesday, and the next day, his administration released details of a federal budget calling for sharp cuts to programs that provide jobs and services in Memphis and Shelby County. We'll assess the impact of the Trump plan. So let's start tonight by introducing our Informed Sources panel. Ron Poe is the he covers city and county government for the Commercial Appeal. And Tanya Weathersby is the CA's Metro columnist. Welcome to you both. Glad to have you here.
Good to be here.
Before we get to the discussion about the president's budget that really impacts Memphis and Shelby County, Tanya, I want to start with you because the president made another one of his patented campaign-style rallies Wednesday, this time in the state capital of Nashville. It was well attended. Of course, there were protesters out there as well. And he made statements during that rally. Certainly, he was not happy about the latest federal court decisions on his travel restrictions. Give me your assessment of the rally, and what do you make of it?
It's really all he knows. I mean, that's what helped him to get elected, and that's what he knows best is how to rouse people up during rallies. It's what he does. Is what he does, and that's something that he knows that works to get people, you know, to come to his side. So he's gonna probably always be in a campaign mode because that's what he knows how to do best. and you know, and I thought it was telling that you had a lot of empty seats at this campaign this time. He's not packing them in the way he used to, but I mean that's his modus operandi. Whenever he has some kind of defeat or something in the courts or in any other area, he goes to his safe corner, and his safe corner is to have these rallies. He had one in Florida. He goes to friendly crowds to get, you know, some reassurance and those types of things. And hey, that's what he does. Well, he likes the adulation.
Give a counter view, there were other elected officials there, including Governor Bill Haslam, who has not been seen with President Trump very much. And he did talk some substance when he talked a little bit about the repeal and replace of Obamacare and some of the other issues. So there may have been some policy substance in addition to the campaign style. Would you agree with that, though?
Well, there may have been some policy substance, but keep in mind that that Governor Haslam hadn't been seen with him before, but he came out this time because I think it's pretty much customary that when the president visits the state officials normally go and they make an appearance with them. Of course, in a lot of states, unfortunately, this has not happened with President Obama.
It didn't happen in Tennessee with Obama.
It certainly didn't happen in Florida with President Obama. But, you know, but for the most part, that's what they do. They have to come and do that. But, I don't think that's a big deal.
Okay. let me bring this closer to home. And Ryan, I'm going to come to you on this because the very next day, the Trump administration released this budget for the next year. And I think you even wrote a story about it that talked about the impact that a lot of the cuts in this budget will have on Memphis and Shelby County. As a matter of fact, I think we have a graphic that we'll show our viewers listing some of the agencies and some of the programs that will be impacted. I'm talking about community development block grants, Meals on Wheels, the Memphis Area Legal Services, the WIC program, Memphis Housing Authority, Minority Business Development. You wrote about this. Talk a little bit more about the impact of all of this if this happens.
Yeah, the impact if it happens would be devastating, as one person put it to me. These are programs that a lot of people in Memphis rely on, as do a lot of people in cities across the country. Maybe less in rural areas, but in inner cities, these programs are essential to a lot of people's lifestyles. So it'll be a huge impact. In particular, one thing that it could do is take away the funding, the $6 million used to pay for the salaries of 80 city employees. Yeah. The city will have to make up that funding somehow. They think they can do it, but they don't know how yet, I was told. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of unanswered questions. Whether the budget actually gets passed, I think, is another big question. A lot of people have said they don't think it will, at least not with all the cuts that you see in it right now.
And Tanya, as someone who writes about social issues quite often, when you look at what's possibly impacted here, what stands out to you in terms of programs that will impact Memphis?
The community development block grants is the first thing. I mean, for years and years, cities have depended on community development block grants to fund a lot of essential services, various services, you know, that you know, people can't raise money to do when you live in an impoverished community. I mean, that ranges from everything from, you know, various feeding, not just Meals on Wheels, but various feeding programs. If you have a nonprofit group that's meeting a certain need and you can't get money elsewhere, a lot of those folks could go to the community, could get something through the community development block grant. And some of those programs have done a lot of good, from, you know, child feeding programs, you know, certain educational tutorial programs, things like that. I'm not sure how it's laid out here in Memphis right now, but I know where I'm from, it's been used for a lot of programs that have done a lot of good. Even some small business, some things that can give seed money for little businesses and mm-hmm. things like that. Okay. If you had a good idea, you could usually go and they could find that money. And those are the things that help people towards self-sufficiency okay. and to get on their feet. But if that goes, then you lost that connection as well.
Okay.